Hi traders, shorting AAP right here. Okay, I am short 4,000 shares. That's a very, very nice reversal. I like the way it looks. It gapped down, pulled back up, and now reversing. That's where my stop loss should be. I'll take a look at the daily too. Daily is always very, very important. Here it is, downtrending. Okay, that looks like a nice potential trade. Here it goes. Here it goes. Okay, okay, doing good. It's down 40 cents from my entry, taking a partial right now. Okay, that's a lovely trade. My first trade for the day, up $1,400. That's a good way to start my trading day. DBD is down 17%. I love this 2320 area, and not only because it's a nice bear flag. Look at the number of buyers at 2320. Once it moves out under 2320, it's probably going to crack down. Now the lows is 2315, but I think that I should in fact short it before that. Oh, I missed it. Look at this 25 cents move that I missed. I never chase stock. Only if it's going to bounce back up, I'm going to short it. Here we go. Okay, not good enough. Maybe 2305. I'm willing to take that price. Okay, shorted at 2305. Never ever chase a stock down. What you just seen me doing is very, very important. When you miss a trade like I did, and hopefully it will continue lower now, when you miss a trade like I did, you do not chase the trade down. You just wait for a pullback. If the pullback comes in within a few seconds, really, you should take it. You don't want to wait too long, because if you wait too long, this pullback may not be just a pullback. It may be a change of direction, and here it goes. Okay, come on, come down under 23, whole number. Okay, and we are under the lows. And look at AAP, amazing. Okay, doing good with DBD. About to take my partial at any pullback now. That was a nice trade. I mean, nothing to write home about, just $200 and something, but the most important part to remember, again, never chase a stock. O'Reilly, I love this basing formation over here. Okay, right now, I'm still thinking. I want to short it, but it's a huge stop loss. Okay, I'll take a ridiculous number of shares, 200 shares only. Shorting. Just above 183, because I think it's just about to move down, or not. Small number of shares. You have to survive big, big pullbacks with a stock like O'Reilly. My stop loss is 2 points, as you can see right over here, over 185. It moves over this level, I'm done. So I have to leave it some space. I thought it's going to break down under 183 real quick. It came down with nice momentum, at least I thought so. So right now I have to wait for it to come back down. But again, if you give it enough space, well, I'm down almost $1 now. No, it's coming back down. Okay, it looks good. If it comes back down to the 183, it's gonna go. Watching the market too, because the market did pull back up exactly when the gap was closed. And I think that the market should be stopping somewhere around here and continue lower. So at that point, after the market pulled up, I may get some help. Although O'Reilly is down 16%, therefore, here we go, under 183, finally. Okay, my target is also $2. So I'm looking for a partial at around 181. My entry was exactly 183. I have like, okay, 70 cents now, not bad. But the big issue, of course, is the 182. Again, watching the market's supposed to help me if it stops here, but it didn't. In fact, it's going against me. So I'm a little bit worried. No, we just moved under 182. O'Reilly does have a life of its own today, apparently. When the stock is down 17%, you would expect that, but you can't really trust that. Now the market should stop right here. It's the S&P 500 here, and here we go. Okay, getting close to my target. Getting close to my target. I'm going to take a 150 share partial needs to get close to 181. I don't expect it to move quickly under 181 because again, it's a whole number. It's at my target right now, but I'm trailing it down, hoping it's not going to bounce. If it will bounce, I will have to take my partial real quick because it's a big mover. There we go. There we go. Come on, break down 181. Break down 181. Let's see you do that. Let's see you do that. At any pullback, I'm going to take my partial. Almost $2 now. At my target. Now. Well, actually took $1.50. That's good. That's okay. Left 50 shares. Over $300. That's my third consecutive positive trade. Okay, traders, I am doing great. Look at AAP. It's unbelievable. I shorted it at 110.77. It's like 5 something points right now. Amazing. O'Reilly's doing great. DBD did very well too. $500 in DBD. More than a point right now. And of course, O'Reilly still moving down, looking great, up $386. Total $3,800. Doing good for the day? Less than 1 hour. Thank you very much for watching.
Traders, if you like to learn trading, trade live with me and get a funded account without risking your money, click in this corner in order to learn more about my funded accounts program. And if you're not subscribed to this channel, just go ahead and click subscribe. Over here, you can find some of my best live trading videos. And please, if you have any questions, let's have a discussion in the comments below.